The problem is not pleasures. The problem is that pleasure experienced without prior requirement for pursuit is terrible for us. I have great confidence in the human species to work this out, but we are finding now, and we are going to increasingly find, that those who will be successful, young or old, are going to be those people who can create their own internal buffers. They're going to be able to control their relationship to pleasures, because the proximity to pleasures and their availability is the problem. If you look at the increase in use of drugs of abuse or prescription medication, huge dopamine increases are what those cause. That is a problem. That's a serious problem, because it creates a cycle where you need more of that specific thing. I would say addiction is a progressive narrowing of the things that bring you pleasure.
God, that's such a good definition.
And a good life, we could say, is a progressive expansion of the things that bring you pleasure, and includes pleasure through motivation and hard work. If you look at any drug of abuse or any situation where somebody isn't motivated, now they may have clinically diagnosed attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, but a lot of what people think is ADHD, it turns out, is people just over-consuming dopamine from various sources. And then, and also the context within a TikTok feed, is the context switch is insane. Normally you walk from one room to another, or from a field into the trees, or from a hut into, or a house, or whatever it is. But now you can get 10,000 context switches in that 30 minutes of scrolling on Instagram or TikTok. When you think, I'm feeling low, I don't feel good, nothing really feels like good, am I depressed? Maybe. But maybe you've saturated the dopamine circuits, you're now in the pain part of things. What do? Well, you have to stop. You need to replenish dopamine. You need to stop engaging with this behavior, and then your pleasure for it will come back. You know, there have been really good studies of people who jump out of airplanes with parachutes. You know, I'm sure it's a lot of fun. It looks like a thrill, but people do it over and over and over again, often die doing other things. They often become drug addicts, because it's a
really?
Huge high. Oh yeah. Yeah, a lot of that. And you know, there are a lot of examples of this. I mean, you can get addicted to anything. The key is to regulate that behavior. So you asked what should people do? Well, I'm actually trying an odd experiment, which is for the first hour of every day, no phone. Mostly because
I think— Part of your 25 no-goes?
Yes, I have a bunch of no-goes.
Really interesting.
Right, so we have circuitry in the brain related to the so-called basal ganglia. And we have goes, sort of activating, you know, think gas pedal. And then there's a lot of no-go circuitry. And learning how to keep that no-go, don't circuitry, tuned up is very important. And so many times throughout the day, but I try and get 25 a day, where I actively refrain from doing something that I impulsively want to do. Could be looking at my phone, but it could even be something trivial. Like I want to walk to the kitchen and get a glass of water. So I'm actively engaging in action-based denial. So restricting my behavior in some way as a way of keeping these dopamine circuits tuned up. Also not looking at my phone first thing in the morning for an hour. When you wake up in the morning, you are in a perfect position to what I call receive the download of all the work that your neural circuitry has been doing the night before. But if you immediately go to a sensory experience, especially a rich sensory experience of stuff scrolling by, you're actually missing the information that you processed at night. And even more importantly, that second half of the night during REM sleep is when the emotional weight of things becomes, let's say, you put it on the shelf properly. Things that are important to emotionally register get put in one shelf. Things that were, like the comment you got on Twitter that was triggering, doesn't seem like such a big deal after a good night's sleep. And that's because that second half of sleep is actually when you re-experience these things, but your body can't secrete adrenaline. It's kind of an internal form of therapy, or even trauma therapy.
Yes.
And that's why people who don't get that sleep are very, you know, they're easily agitated. They feel like the world is crushing down on them. So when I wake up in the morning, I want to receive ideas that I want to learn from my learning. And if you take in new information, you are not in a position to do that.